A proxy server is an intermediary server that allows an application or a user to access the internet. For example, a user first connects to the proxy server and sends his request to it from the internal network. The proxy server then forwards the message to the remote server on the internet. It can ensure internet access filtering within a company. It can control access to specific websites or services based on user authentication or authorization rules. This helps prevent access to potentially dangerous sites for the security of the IT system or sites that are not in line with the company's policies, like adult content websites. Because unlike a router, a proxy server acts at the application layer and is able to directly analyze the requests made by the user, which is not the usual role of a router. The second use of a proxy is paradoxically to bypass filtering. Take the example of China, which blocks access to several social media or websites through a firewall. It's possible to bypass this restriction by using a proxy located beyond the firewall in another country. Now, let's look at the main functionalities of a proxy server. The proxy's first functionality is to anonymize users by masking the client's IP. When the proxy communicates with the remote server, it uses a public IP address, concealing the IP of the user who initiated the request. The response from the remote server to the request also passes through the proxy, which is the only entity aware of the user's IP. Then, the proxy server accelerates browsing, mainly through data compression and caching. The caching function involves storing frequently visited web pages in memory to provide them more quickly. When the user wants to access a web page, the proxy checks to see if it has a recent copy of the page on hand. If so, it is directly provided to the user. Finally, the proxy enables connection tracking through logs. The proxy records user requests when they connect to the internet. When filtering is based on an authorized request list, it's referred to as a whitelist. When filtering is done using a list of forbidden sites, it's a blacklist. Now, let's move on to what a reverse proxy is. As the name suggests, the reverse proxy performs the reverse role of a regular proxy. The reverse proxy enables external users from the internet to access internal servers. It serves as an intermediary for security, protecting internal web servers from external attacks. The reverse proxy provides a point for filtering access to internal resources. The reverse proxy examines the incoming request, which includes details like the requested URL, headers, and other metadata. Now let's examine the main functionalities of a reverse proxy. The reverse proxy can handle SSL encryption and decryption, but also connect to authentication servers to manage access rights and session duration. This minimizes the computational load on back-end servers. Then, a reverse proxy can optimize web performance by handling tasks like content compression, image optimization, and caching. By serving cached or optimized content directly from the reverse proxy, it results in faster response times for users. Finally, the reverse proxy can achieve load balancing by redirecting requests to different servers to prevent overload and ensure optimal performance. Thanks a bunch for tuning in. I trust you found it both educational and entertaining. To stay in the loop with all things tech and computer science, be sure to click that subscribe button and ring that notification bell. See you soon.